Hello everyone, I am Saurabh Pandey and I am a Microsoft Certified Professional. SQLDepository.com is my blog and I upload all my videos on my YouTube channel, which is SQL Space Depository. And I also have a Facebook page, which is www.facebook.com/SQL Depository. So in this session, we are going to talk about a few of the execution plan operators like compute, scalar, and convergence. And then we'll also talk about parameter sniffing. So let's move on to the demo. Okay. So for this demo, I'm going to create a stored procedure which has two input parameter, which is unit price and tax amount. And both these input parameters are float parameters. And these two parameters are going to be compared with the unit price and tax amount column in sales order header and sales order detail tables, which are here. So these two tables are here, sales order detail and sales order header. Okay. So let me go ahead and create this procedure. Okay. So now this procedure has been created. So I'm going to run this procedure with some parameter values. And this is exactly the same procedure. I'm going to run this procedure with the parameter values 2 and 5. And 2 is the unit price here and 5 is the tax amount. Okay. So let me go ahead and execute this. And this is completed. Oops, I forgot to include the execution plan. So I'm going to run this one more time and then we'll see what exactly is the execution plan here. Okay, so now I can see the execution plan, and if I'll see this execution plan, I can see a compute scalar and constant scan operator before sales order detail table and also before sales order header table. Now, what exactly these constant scan and compute scalar operators doing here? So to understand that, I'll have to go back to the procedure definition, and if I'll see my procedure definition here, both the input parameters, which are unit price and tax amount, both are float parameters, right? And it is being compared with unit price and tax amount column. Okay, so I'll go and check what exactly these two columns are, which is unit price and tax amount. So tax amount column is in sales order header table, and if I'll see the tax amount column here, it is declared, it has been created with the data type money, right? And similarly, if I'll check the other column, which is unit price column in sales order detail table, here it is, and it is also a money column. So now this is exactly the problem is. So if I'll go back to the execution plan, now I can tell you what exactly constant scan and compute scalar operators doing here, because these two parameters are being compared with the unit price and tax amount values in those two tables. And as those two columns are money columns, and it is being compared with the float data type, the parameter which has been declared as float. So for that to perform this where clause and perform this operation, it is constantly scanning those two column values, and then it is passing to compute scalar, and compute scalar is performing the conversion from money to float so that it can be compared with the float values. So this is exactly why this constant scan and compute scalar operators coming in the execution plan. Now, how exactly I can remove these two operators from my execution plan, because these two operators are not good when it comes to performance. And to remove these two operators from the execution plan, what I'm going to do, I'm going to alter the definition of my procedure. And this time I'm going to declare these two input parameters as money parameters. And it will now have money values. And now in the where clause, the comparison will happen between money and money data type. It is not going to happen between money and float data type this time. So let me go ahead and alter the definition of the procedure. And this is done now. And now if I'll run this procedure with the exactly same parameter values again, you'll find almost the same execution plan, except those two constant scalar and constant scan and compute scalar operators are not there in the execution plan now. Okay, so we have removed those two operators which were not good in the execution plan. Okay, so now we'll talk about talk a little about the parameter sniffing. So first I'll just run this parameter with different parameter values, and then we'll try to understand what exactly the parameter sniffing is. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna mark this procedure to recompile in the next execution, and it is done. Now I'm gonna run this procedure one more time, and it will return the same execution plan. So let's go ahead and execute this, and yes, it has returned the same execution plan, which is fine. But now if I'll run this procedure with the different parameter values, which is 4000 and 7500, let's see how much time it takes and what exactly the execution plan is. So I have already executed this procedure. This procedure will take a couple of seconds, maybe more than 20 seconds to execute for these two parameter values. And once it will be it will complete, we'll check the execution plan, and then we'll try to reduce the execution time by using different methods. So it is already 26 seconds, 27. So it should complete any time now. So it has taken 29 seconds. Okay. So if I'll check the execution plan here, you can see it is exactly the same execution plan, but you can see many fat lines here. Okay. Actually, there are two problems right now that I can see in this execution plan. So we'll talk about it one by one. But first, we'll talk about what exactly the parameter sniffing is. So this is the stored procedure, and stored procedure use the cached execution plan until unless it is not marked to recompile or something like that, right? So first time when we ran this procedure with the parameter values 2 and 5, it generated this execution plan, and it has to reuse the execution plan for every execution from here onwards. Okay. And then I've changed the input parameter values, and then it is still using the same exactly same execution plan, but this execution plan is not efficient here. This is exactly the parameter sniffing is, which is not necessarily a problem, but sometimes it may create the problem, and this is the case here right now. Because if you'll let me just talk about different kind of joins in the execution plan. So there are three different joins in the execution plan, which is nested loop, merge join, and hash match. Okay. So nested join is efficient join for the small number of rows. Number of rows are not too many, then nested join works perfectly fine, which was indeed the case when I ran the stored procedure with the parameter values 2 and 5. That time less number of rows were coming, and it has created a nested loop join here. Okay, but now this time, if you'll see the number of records here, actual number of rows, how many are they? They are too many. These are maybe 75,000. No, these are 758,688 rows. Okay, and from this table, the actual number of rows are 698,290, which is too many rows for nested join. So nested join, nested loop join do not perform efficiently when the number of rows are too many. Okay, let's talk about other two kind of join, which is hash match and merge join. So merge join actually need the data in the sorted format. The data should be sorted in on the basis of your joining predicate. So if I'll have to tell you what exactly the joining predicate here, then you'll have to look at this when I'm talking about the, when I'm joining the table sales order header and sales order detail. So joining predicate here is sales order ID. So if it is, it has an index which has been created on sales order ID, and the data is coming in the sorted format on the basis of sales order ID, then it will go for merge join if number of rows are too many. Okay, but it also has to satisfy this where clause as well. So maybe many times if you have the index for on the join predicate, still it will not pick up those indexes because it may go for the index which will satisfy those conditions. Okay, so in those cases, what SQL Server will do? SQL Server will go for hash match, which does not require the data in the sorted format, but it will take the data from inner and outer table and it will create a hash table in the memory. Okay, and this hash table will be in sorted format and there it will perform the join. So this is exactly what it is doing here. But there is one more problem in this execution plan. The problem is this little yellow mark here, which is a warning sign. And if you'll see the warning, operator used DB to spill data during execution. So this is another problem in this execution plan here. And this indicates the memory pressure. Because on my laptop, there is not enough memory to create a hash table in the memory. So the entire operation is spilled into the temp DB and it has acquired the temp DB space to create the hash table. And this is known as temp DB spill. And as it is a physical IO operation and disk will get included in this, then it becomes a big problem here. So these kind of scenarios, whenever you will see these kind of yellow marks on hash match or in the aggregation operators, then you should take care of your memory because most of the times this is temp DB spill and temp DB spill is not good for your query execution time. Okay, so I'll talk about temp DB spill more in some other video, but let's talk about parameter sniffing first. So the problem here is, which is related to parameter sniffing, is this nested loop. Okay, because it has already created an execution plan and it is reusing the cached execution plan. And this time for these two new parameter values, this execution plan is not efficient. Okay, so what exactly we can do about it? So before telling you what exactly we can do about it, I'm going to mark this procedure again for recompile. Okay, now next time if I'll run this procedure, it will create a new execution plan. And rather than running the parameter with these two parameter values, I'm going to run this procedure with these two parameter values this time, which has taken 29 seconds last time. So let me go ahead and execute this again. And let's see how much time it takes. So 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds. So it is more than 300% improvement, right? And if I will see the execution plan here, I can see another hash match. So this time both the joining operators are hash match operators. Okay, and the query completed really much faster. Okay, so now I marked this procedure to recompile manually, which is not a solution, right? So what exactly the solution is in those kind of scenarios? So there are many solutions for these kind of scenarios and it varies from procedure to procedure and environment to environment. So you'll have to use your wisdom which solution you are gonna use in these kind of scenarios in your environment. But let me discuss each of them. So one of the solution is mark your, use with recompile option in your stored procedure. So at the stored procedure level, if you'll use with recompile, then you'll have to write with recompile here. And every time when the procedure will run, doesn't matter if it is for same parameter values or different parameter values, it will recompile a new execution plan. But right now I have only one select query in the procedure, but your procedure might have many other queries, but this parameter sniffing problem is only associated with one of your queries. So in that case, you'll not prefer to write with recompile here because it will recompile the execution plan for the entire procedure. Rather, you can use the option recompile at the statement level and it will recompile a new execution plan for this particular statement every time. Okay, so I'm gonna use that. But if you have a single statement in your procedure which is causing the problem and this is the only statement there, then you can use at the procedure level as well. Okay, so let me go ahead and execute this. rather I should say alter the definition of the procedure. Now it has been altered, and now I'm gonna run this procedure with the parameter values 2 and 5 again, and it is giving me the exactly same execution plan which is it was giving for parameter values 2 and 5 before, the hash match and one nested loop, right? But now if I'll run this procedure for these two parameter values without marking this procedure for recompile again, will it use the exactly same execution plan or it will change the execution plan? So let's see what happens this time. Okay, so it is running. It is going to take a couple of seconds, but I'm not expecting it to go 29 seconds, which it has taken earlier. So this is creating the execution plan. So it has taken few seconds extra, but that's not a problem. It is definitely not 29 seconds, which was the case earlier. And if you'll see the execution plan, this is the exactly same execution plan which was created after recompile last time, right? So it has changed the execution plan. It is not using the same execution plan again, and you don't have to do it manually. Your procedure, the statement inside the procedure has been marked to recompile every time. But is marking your statement for recompile every time is an option? The problem here is, suppose you are running this procedure with the exactly same two parameter values multiple times, still it will create the new execution plan, which might be exactly the same every time, but it will waste a few milliseconds, microseconds, or few seconds to create a new execution plan every time. Which will be same if you are using the same parameter values and there is no change in the table, but still you are wasting some time by recompiling the execution plan, recompiling the procedure, recompiling the execution plan for your statement every time, right? So I don't actually need it. If it is the parameter values are same, why would you recompile it every time? So the another solution here is, so let me go down, and what I've done here, this is exactly the same procedure, but I've at the end I have given option optimize for unknown. Okay, so let me go ahead and create this stored procedure, and then I'm gonna run those two this procedure with those two parameter values again, and for this there is no problem. It has again completed in no time, and but this time the only difference here is earlier for the parameter values 2 and 5 it was creating the execution plan with one hash match and one nested loop, but this time it has created the execution plan with both the hash matches, even for the parameter values 2 and 5. That's because this time it is not using your stats data, it is rather using, okay, let me open one stat here, and let me see exactly what exactly the index it is using. So on sales order header IX underscore 11 it is. So let me go to the index, actually to stats, not index, and let me open this. Okay, and I'll go to the detail, and here if you'll see here, it gives you the range and the density, everything, right? So densities are here, which is average density, and this is the range and number of rows. So these kind of details here. So earlier it was using this histogram, but when I used the option, which is here, if I'll go down, when I use the option which is optimized for unknown, rather than using this histogram steps, it is using the density now. So it is working on the average density of the table for that particular column here. So what column it is? So this table is sales order header table, and for sales order header, I have tax amount. So it is working on the average density of the tax amount column. So if I'll just maximize it, And here you can see for column tax amount, this is the density. So this is using this density to create the execution plan. And no matter with what parameter you will run your stored procedure first time after restarting or flushing your plans, it will always use this and it will always come up with the same execution plan. Okay, so now this time it is not using it is not at all using the nested loop, but this is not at all a problem for these two parameter values because it is still completing in no time. But here it will give you lots of improvement because now without recompiling, I have the efficient execution plan for these two parameter values. Okay, so this by doing this, I can get the rid of parameter the problem related to parameter sniffing. Because parameter sniffing is a default behavior, but the problem associated with parameter sniffing was that, and I could get the rid of the problem which was related to parameter sniffing, right? Okay, so this is another way. I can show you one more view which is more or less same. So what exactly I'm doing here? So for these two input parameters, actually I have declared two variables inside the definition of a stored procedure, and I'm dumping the values of these two input parameters into these two variable which I have declared inside the stored procedure, and then I'm using these two variables rather than using these two input parameters for the comparison. So now what happened here, at the time of execution plan creation, your SQL doesn't know the values of these two variables, which is unit price one and tax amount one. So as it doesn't know the value, so it cannot use the histogram. So what option your cardinality estimator will have? The only option it will have is using this density. So this is exactly same as option optimized for unknown, but it is just another way of doing it. So if I'll do this, I'll see the exactly same behavior which I could see in case of option optimized for unknown. So let me go ahead and run this execution plan again, and it is gonna use your density of tax amount and unit price columns. So it will again come up with the same execution plan which has two hash matches, and you'll not see that nested loop in the execution plan. Okay, and this execution plan is efficient for these two parameter values also. So your stored procedure for these two parameter values will also work fine. So this is one more way to get the rid of the problem related to parameter sniffing. There are few other ways also, like rather than using optimize for unknown, you can use optimize for for these two parameter values. You can say optimize for unit price equal to 4000 and tax amount equal to 7500. So it will create the execution plan which is efficient for these two parameter values, no matter with what parameter value you are running the procedure. So that could be another way of doing it, but I'm not gonna go in the detail of that. So these are the few ways to get the rid of probably related to performance tuning, right? So in this session we have discussed about constant scan, compute scalar operator, and we have also discussed why exactly these operators appear in your execution plan and how exactly you can get the rid of it. And then we also talked about parameter sniffing and few different ways to get the rid of the problems related to parameter sniffing. So this is what I wanted to cover in this session. Thank you for watching this session.